Squeaks. You sure have been looking up a lot of pictures of sea monsters since we got back from the beach. Oh, our trip to the ocean inspired you? So you're doing research for a special art project? What is it? You're designing your own sea monster? That's such a great idea! You know, I bet you could get some inspiration from real animals too. Well, even though sea monsters aren't exactly real, there have been lots of really big, strong animals that have lived in the ocean. And even though they aren't alive anymore, we can learn what they looked like from their fossils. Fossils are anything that tells us about life in the ancient past. They can be bones, teeth, footprints, and all kinds of things. In fact, looking at fossils from ancient ocean creatures might be a great place to find inspiration for your sea monster design. How about you tell me what features you want your sea monster to have, and I'll help you look for real-life inspiration. Let's get started. Ah, you want your monster to be able to swim around the ocean. Well, that makes sense. Let's start off by checking out this fossil. Yes, this one has a super long neck. These fossils come from an animal called a plesiosaur. Plesiosaurs were really big reptiles that lived around the same time as dinosaurs, but plesiosaurs lived in oceans. This plesiosaur, called an elasmosaurus, had a neck that was over 6 meters long. That's longer than 2 cars put together. Plesiosaurs' long necks and sharp teeth helped them to catch fish to eat. They also had something to help them get around in the water. Yes, flippers! Instead of hands and feet like we have, the plesiosaurs had flippers, kind of like a seal. These made plesiosaurs pretty great swimmers. And plesiosaurs had another giant cousin in the ocean too. Take a look at this. It does kind of look like an alligator. This is an animal called Tylosaurus, which is a kind of mosasaur. Mosasaurs were also giant reptiles that lived in the ocean. They first evolved around 75 million years ago. They were huge like plesiosaurs, but they looked a bit different. What special features do you notice, Squeaks? Yes! Instead of a long neck like plesiosaurs, mosasaurs had powerful tails that helped them to swim, but they both had really big pointy teeth to help them catch their food. Mosasaurs ate all kinds of other animals, fish, birds, even other mosasaurs. So Squeaks, did any of those animals give you any ideas? Oh, your monster will have flippers and a long tail to help it swim quickly so it can catch its prey. Great! What's next? Oh, your monster needs to be tough, eh? Ooh, that reminds me of one of my favorite ancient sea monsters, the Dunkleosteus. Dunkleosteus is a giant fish from a group called placoderms. Can you see what special feature is my favorite about Dunkleosteus? Yes, its head is covered in bony plates that make it look a little like it's wearing a helmet that a knight in shining armor might wear. In fact, these animals are sometimes called armor-headed fish. Dunkleosteus were really big, almost as long as a school bus, and they needed a lot of food for their big bodies. Sometimes they would even try to eat other placoderms. Their giant, thick skulls worked like armor and might have helped keep them safe from other big predators. What do you think, Squeaks? Squeaks' monster will be covered with bony plates to keep it safe. What's next for your monster? Oh, your monster needs to look ferocious. Well, there is another ancient sea animal that we could get some ideas from. One that might be a little more familiar. Take a look. Ooh, you're right. It does look like a shark tooth. And sharks are still around today too, but they've been around for a really long time. Sharks first evolved way before the dinosaurs. And in the past, there were sharks much bigger than the ones we have around now. This tooth is from a megalodon, the biggest type of shark that ever lived. Compare it to the tooth from a great white shark. What do you notice, Squeaks? Yes, the megalodon tooth is much bigger. Megalodons were enormous. Megalodons could grow at least 45 feet long, or 15 meters. That's as long as a semi-truck. If you look really closely at the edges of the megalodon's tooth, you might notice one more feature that helped them eat their prey. Their teeth have serrated edges, which means they have little bumps along the sharp side, like a bread knife. These made megalodon teeth super sharp and good at slicing into their prey. Ooh, yeah! I think a set of big serrated teeth would be the perfect addition to your sea monster. It sounds like you have a lot of great ideas to make a really fearsome sea monster. It's got flippers like a plesiosaur, a strong tail like a mosasaur, bony armor like a Dunkleosteus, and serrated teeth like a megalodon. Let's see how it turned out. Now that is an amazing sea monster, Squeaks! I hope learning about these animals from the past gave you some fun ideas for designing a sea monster too. What special traits would you want to give your own sea monster design? Thanks for joining us, and remember to hit the subscribe button to keep exploring with Squeaks, me, and all our friends. And we'll see you next time here at the fort.